My name is Nasser Pirasteh, and I'm a sculptor artist. I work with stone, I-beam, iron, bronze, and all kinds of hard materials. I like to work pretty much with some reason why am I doing this. I grew up in a family of artists. My father is a painter. I saw my father always with the canvas and brushes and oil painting and portraits and realistically very perfect, beautiful work he did. And this is the way I grew up. We had a lot of discussion and talk about it. I would saturate that and then move it to another dimension in my mind in those earlier ages. You know, painting was, to me, it was just a I couldn't understand the dimensions as a two or three, but I felt to experience my hands, my fingers. So obviously I had to play and do with the clay. But I was always inspired with what was going around me. It was talk about art, and paintings were always around. The first, I remember in early age of 6 years old, I remember I did old king with the clay. And the way I did it, or how the response of that earthy material through my fingers, you know, and the satisfaction of that material, it seems like I discovered something new over the painting. From that moment on, I knew this is going to be my first interest. I did receive my Bachelor of Art in St. Cloud State University in 1974. And 2 years later, 1976, I got my Master of Fine Art in Sculptor, and also I got second Master in the Jewelry in 3D. The way I start thinking and the way I see the things in me starts as a spark, either from my own or injecting somehow with the outside. And then I see as a triangle here between me and what work I'm gonna do and the viewers.
Now, this piece that Nasser has created speaks to me very personally on two levels. One, I love again the integration of the man-made iron and the God-made stone. But I also love the fact that this is not just art, but this is industrial useful material. I'm a speaker. I collect art, but I also speak to people. And a podium like this is such a beautiful thing to work from. I don't care if the people look at me. They can look at the art and just hear what I have to say. Love is not an ornament. It's the essence of life. It's carved right here on the stone and in Farsi on the other side. And whatever paper I put over that to read from is going to carry that message, because it's deeply ingrained in the art that is the podium that is supporting everything that I'm presenting. This is so exciting as a useful piece of art, as well as a beautiful, beautiful piece of art.
This triangle to me, it just keep going on. It just goes on.
I love Nasser's work. The piece Journey I found deeply moving on a spiritual and an emotional level, being able to see a piece of art in front of me that actually captured the transformation of a woman's life was incredible. It's a gift.
If I'm not there when they look at my work, hopefully they get to understand how do I think and why do I think that way, or why am I doing and saying this?
And obviously a meteor shower, as he's entitled it, and you see the interaction between the elements in the piece. It talks to me of conflict, and it talks to me of conflict resolution over time with the rust trails that'll develop over time. It's an emotive piece.
It's the way my language is. It's the way I feel to put it and form it and shape it with the symbols, with the whatever I am doing with that particular subject. And then when I'm done with it in my mind. I put it out there. I'm hoping people are going to see and react to it, and they're going to get it, what this is. Truly, when there are a lot of moments, a lot of days, I feel I need to be outside. My mind is out there. I just want to get going. I am so anxious to break that stone or cut that stone or bend that I-beam. I'm not saying I'm a Superman or something, but I feel like that way. I just want to heat it up and bend it and cut it and do. I just want to see it, what happens. So I want to touch it and feel it. The interesting part is when I go through this process, sometimes I get surprised myself because the metal, the stone reacts to me, or the good surprises are there always. It's just that drives me always so anxiously to get into work. There are places I really don't want to be. I want to be with my tools, and if the tool breaks, that's my obstacle. Seems like I have so much to say. Seems like I have so much to show, more than anybody to myself. I think I'm very lucky because every time somebody sees my work, I gain a friend. Every time I sell a piece, I definitely gain a friend. And truly, I am so excited. This is the nice way to add to the list of my friends. What my interest is for today and future, I have a lot of sketches, a lot of ideas I've documented already, and I'm not gonna be exact where I'm gonna be tomorrow, another 3, 4, 5 years, but for now I'm having a lot of fun. What I'm enjoying and respond what I'm getting from people, they're enjoying too, so I'm gonna keep continue. When it comes to material, that is open. That is open to the subject, what I'm going to use.